Wonderful people, fellow couch gamers, welcome back to Couch Gaming TV. My name is Sunny and I will take you all with me to Let's Play Skyrim Remastered Extreme Modded Survival Episode 8. That was a mouthful. I think I forgot to mention which episode we were at last episode, but if I ever make a mistake or call out a wrong episode, like I said before, the title is always right, because I can edit the title as much as I want, but I cannot edit my voice. What are you yabbering about? Oh, it's not you. Nazim.
Do you get to the Cloud District very often? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you don't.
The Cloud District, is that in Cyrodiil? Is that in the Imperial City? Because I think it is.
I want to just right now. Father promised.
All you ever do is complain about what you want. You're a spoiled baby.
I'm going to tell Father you said that. He'll tan you.
Look at that poor fella. Look at that poor fella in the middle of this meddling kit.
My lord, our provisions.
I don't care about you lot.
Our stores of meat, wine, and grain are all but depleted.
Let's not forget to sell a couple of potions before we head out. Do you have anything else with us to sell? I don't think so. I think we only have potions. Oh yeah, and some armor as well. Yep, potions and armor. Potions and armor. I wasn't going to do another episode, but I want to go over to a friend, but he's still sleeping. I hope he wakes up by the end of this episode, otherwise I will have no idea what to do next. That's a fine looking axe. Forgot how it is called. Come on, your loading screen. I never have much idea what to say during loading screens. Nice view. Oh, baby. That's where we need to go. But first we need to go to the Bleakfell's barrels, which is right above our head. Right over there. Man, this is a nice view. I wish we could fly straight up to the sky right now so we could get even a better view. Oops. 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 Doesn't take much effort to get out of in the city. Yeah, I just wanted to take a quick gander at the view. And right now we are going to refill our water skins. Let's join these eggs first, or barnacles, barnacle clams, salmon meat, okay, that's good too. Let's get some air, let's take all these barnacle clams. These are pretty rare to find. Some more barnacle clams here. Yep, they were hidden behind beneath the rocks. We don't need more salmons, not for the moment. Okay, let's refill these water skins. Water skin empty. Unknown. It's poisonous water. Of course it is. Of course it is. Three loaves of bread. Three whole breads. That's a lot. Well, he's a big man after all. He needs lots of food. Are we well sated? We are not well. We are well hydrated. Okay. Well sated means that we are not hungry anymore. Well hydrated means that we are not thirsty anymore. I gotta keep those two in mind. Because, as you know or may not know, I'm a foreigner. So my English isn't perfect. Can we light these braziers? No, we cannot. I think these braziers light up automatically during the night. I believe they do. I hear some shouting over there. What's that? Screw you and screw your goddamn empire, man. I'm a Stormcloak. I only trust myself. And my other self. Of course. Potion shop. Acadia's Cauldron. Is it Acadia? I just saw an A and a C. Arcadia. Okay, Arcadia. That sounds familiar. Isn't that like a settlement in The Walking Dead, Arcadia? Isn't that a cannibalist settlement? I believe it is. Hi there, Arcadia. You're not gonna eat me, are you? Salves, poultices, and potions on my shelves. Browse to you got a mustache. Ma'am, you have a mustache. You have to shave that, ma'am.
You look rather pale. Could be ataxia. It's quite a problem. Ah, so you're an alchemist then.
I'm not pale, I'm like yellowish green. Ah, so you're an alchemist then. Yes, we are an alchemist. You know why? Because you're a monkey lover. Yeah, you are, you monkey. Let's buy all the cheap shit to make some more expensive shit. Wisp wrappings, ooh. And it only costs 6. Mortar and pestle. I cannot remember those being in the game. Those were in Oblivion. Mortar, pestle, embalming fluid or whatever it was. To increase the strength of your potions, but I cannot remember that. This is odd. I think this is from a mod. Let's not purchase that just yet. Just gonna sell all the useless ones. Well, not that potions are actually useless, but let's sell all the ones that are worth a whole lot. Health is increased by 19 points. 19 points is not gonna help us that much. So we might as well sell all of these. Was that a good idea? I hope it was a good idea. Because we need the money. We need the money. Ooh, wait, 300. Yep. That's good, that's good, that's good.
Come back anytime if you need a remedy.
Oh, off to the blacksmiths or to the general store. Is there actually, did the game freeze? The game fucking froze. Yeah. Come on, 8 minutes, 9 minutes and then the game freezes. What the hell, Skyrim? What the hell, man? Well, now that we need to load for like 300 minutes, and believe me, it's gonna take 300 minutes, I'm gonna eat some chicken fillet with garden spices. Filet de poulet. What is it? Filet de poulet. I'm an expert at French. Manger le filet de poulet. I fucking hate French. You know why I hate French? Because they rub it in my face. all the freaking time. Half of the stuff on Xbox Live is in French. You got like 50% of your game is in French, 40% is in English, and 10% is in Dutch. I'm not shitting you. That's how it is over in Belgium. You want to play Fallout 3? You want to play Fallout New Vegas? Oh, good luck, mate. Good luck. Good luck. 30% of the game is going to be in English, and 70% of the fucking game is going to be in French. You want to play Dragon Quest? Not going to happen unless you can speak fluently French. You want to play Gears of War? Not going to happen unless you can speak French. You want to play NBA? Not going to happen unless you can speak French. You want to play Fallout New Vegas? Not going to happen unless you can speak French. Can I give like an example so you guys know what I'm talking about? You see all this stuff that you cannot read or can read? That's in Dutch. Look, look, look. It's fucking English. No. Fucking Dutch and French. Le incorruptible. What the fuck that ever that what the whatever that fucking means. See, look, look. Courroux de Cieux. I cannot fucking even read that. I can't even pronounce that shit. The achievement is in French, yet it says you got an achievement in Dutch. It's the same with the games. Obtainer of rare antiques. This achievement is in English. This one is in English as well. Look, this one is in Dutch. This one is in French. This one is in French as well. Fuck you, Microsoft, for screwing the Belgian people over that hard. And it's been like that since the release of Xbox 360. They haven't fixed it. No, instead, they made it worse. They made it worse. Is Fallout Shelter for free? Fallout Shelter is for free. Nice. Nice. I know a lot of people think that game sucks, but I want to play that game. Nice. Okay, well, I was going to show how much Xbox sucks in Belgium. Like, let's enter Dragon Age. Let's do that. Dragon Age. Let's show all the Dragon Ages to see what's in English, what's in French, what's in fucking Dutch. Oh, it's all in English. It's all in English. How about that? Whoa, and the text is in English as well. Well, can't show any examples right now because we're wasting too much time. But as you can see from the achievements, that some things are written in Dutch, some things are written in English, other things are written in fucking French. Yeah, I mean, look, I'm gonna show you a better achievement if you're still watching, if you haven't killed yourself by now. Skyrim Special Edition achievements. English, Dutch, French. What the fuck? I don't know what that means. 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 I think I know what that means. But I don't know what that means. The fuck? You see that shit? That's some hardcore shit. That's some hardcore shit. Let's check Neverwinter achievements. Those should be in English, right? Tout a une fin. Vous avez tracé Valindre fait une sorte qu'elle ne revient jamais à se perdre en Neverwinter. Did I even pronounce that correctly? Because I have no idea. That sounded alright. That might sounded alright to you because you do not know French just like me. I do not know French and that sounded alright. But I probably mispronounced a whole lot of words there. French, French, French. And there's no fucking way to put them in English or Dutch. Dark Souls, you're gonna be in English, right? See? See, this is in English and Dutch. It's better than English, Dutch and French. It's the Master Pyromancy, Acquire All Pyromancies, that's English. And then the rest is in Dutch. But sometimes you have like a couple of English achievements and then a couple of other achievements are in French. Not here though. Not here. Well, enough yabbering about. Let's continue onwards with playing Skyrim. Yeah, good thing you saved when we entered the shop.
You look rather so you're interested.
You're not gonna freeze again, right? Now we must buy those ingredients again. Blah blah blah. Only one garlic. I thought she had two garlics last time. She has different ingredients. That's odd. Ah, no wisp thingy. I wanted the wisp thingy. We are not gonna sell the health potions. Instead, we are gonna sell these potions. Because we will most likely not use these that much. Stamina. Well, sometimes stamina might be just as important as health. Let's just sell two of these then. And don't you freeze again. Just to be sure, I'm gonna do a save. Not a quick save over the other save. Because if this house keeps glitching out or freezing, we're gonna be stuck inside this house. That's never a good idea. Dragon's Reach earned its name when the ancient Nord hero Olaf One-Eyed imprisoned his foe, the great dragon Numinex, within the palace. I remember that piece of lore. That's some cool piece of lore. I wish I could just carry where... equip, whatever, a dragon's head. That would be awesome. That would be awesome. Come on, you damn loading screen. The reason why I do not have multiple experience enhanced, or however you want to call it, like in Fallout 4, we have 6 times the normal experience there, is because there's so much more to do in Skyrim that gives experience. In Fallout, only killing monsters and finishing quests generally gives experience, but in Skyrim, most things that you do give experience. And we get an extra skill point every other 2 levels. So it's about the same in speed compared to Fallout 4 when we are leveling up. But it's a little bit different. I like variety. Variety is necessary. Who are you? No, you don't. Janessa, who the hell are you?
Blade and shadow.
Oh, you're just a random. Cool, so you...
These are my arts. For a modest fee, I'll make...
You're from a mod as well, are you, right? I think this female is from a mod and she just walks inside the store and has a little talk with Ulfbert. Ulfbert?
Welcome to war, mate. Helmets.
Okay, let's sell deer hide. No. Let's sell this. And the scaled helmets. I think after that we are good to go. 1,000 gold on the button. 1,000 gold on the button. Is there nothing else that we can sell?
Good doing business with you.
What was that, Zero?
We've got small weapons.
take a
what,
look.
What was that, zero? What? What? I'm freaking out again. I thought our gold said zero, but it says 2101. I'm freaking out. I'm a bit thirsty though. I'm gonna shake my chocolate milk. My brick of chocolate milk. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Gonna take a quick sip. Oh yeah. I'm addicted to that shit. Le chocolaté. Antier. Looks like we will have to head out in the rain. Is the torch gonna go out during the rain? I hope not. Bleak Farrell's barrows, here we come, baby. Here we come. We are probably not gonna be strong enough to handle it already. And we might also want to keep in mind that we will probably need a helmet of some sorts to replace this metal headband once we head up to the mountain. Because that metal headband is gonna freeze our brain cells. Yes, it will. Yes, it will. You mark my words. Well, a horse would be nice, but we do not have money for that yet. Can we take the carriage to Riverwood? Let's see if we can take the carriage. That would save us some time. Yo, bro. Riverwood, bro. No? I guess not then.
Good day.
What's that over here? I cannot remember this. This looks out of place. Eh. Alright, back on foot then. Back on foot. We go up to Riverwood. I don't think any dragons are gonna spawn, right? Not until we get up to High Hrothgar, I believe. High Hrothgar. Yeah, we need to go that way, huh? Is that dead wolf? It's a dead wolf. It's one that we killed last time, probably, or someone else killed that one. Either way, it's a dead wolf. You are wet, but not soaking wet yet, huh? That means we can keep going. I hope my friend is gonna be awake, otherwise I'm just gonna phone his cell phone until he... Whoa! What are the odds of that? Quama egg. What the fuck are the odds of that? It's really in the middle of nowhere. These Quama eggs are only a few of many such eggs, decorated by a famed Dunmer artist Indrahalula. Most are assumed to have been destroyed in the eruption of Vardenfell Mountain. Cool. Quana. Quana egg, what you do? That was a potion, I believe. Improved night vision for 90 seconds. Useless. Totally and utterly useless. Well, not exactly useless, but you get my point. The only one that I'm liking so far is the one that gives us a teleport. But don't get me wrong, I like the X. Only if it only be for aesthetic purposes, it doesn't matter. You shouldn't be barking at me, friends. I got the power of the flames! You know what always bothered me in games like this? I kill a wolf, but the meat is still raw. It would be cool if we could somehow... I think I'm gonna sit in here and have a little smoke. Yeah, that looks nice. Would be cool if I have things like this over where I live, but I kind of live in a city. Small city though, but city nonetheless. And the government is destroying all the forests and all the parks and all the playgrounds and everything. There's not much left compared to 15 years ago. Do we need to drop off anything in our house? Well, we might just well. We might just... fuck, I forgot to sell all the gold necklaces and stuff in the general store. We didn't do the general store! What's wrong with me? I say do the potion shop, do the general store, and what do? I do the potion shop and the fucking blacksmith. Doesn't matter much, but still... I don't think we need to drop anything off. Let's just keep going. Bleak Files Barrows. Yes, there it is. Do we need to sleep? No. I wanted to see my needs. We don't need to do anything else, although we might, now that I think of it, because once we are inside Bleak Files Barrows, we are not going to have access to water, I think. So, let's see if our water is filled up. Nope, good thing I check. And now we're gonna cook the water as well, so we don't get diseased inside the Bleak Owl Barrels. I think 2 water skins should be enough. I hope 2 water skins is enough. Well, I was gonna say let's head into the inn and cook. But we might as well head to our house and cook. And now that I think of it, no way to cook inside the inn, I think. So, what the hell is that? The water is cool and refreshing. You are drenched. Yes, bear with me. We're gonna warm up inside our little cabin. My Riverwood house. I love this mod. I had almost deleted that. Was that a money back? Yeah. We walked across these stairs like 50 times already, and now it's the first time I see that money back. Odd. I like to think I always see everything, but you might say that I see everything by noticing that money back below the stairs. But like I said, we've only been like there 50 times, we didn't see it last time. Always press the wrong button. No, bah! These buttons are so different from Fallout 4. Anything? Let's deposit the egg. Is the egg in here? Yes. Oh, fuck! Shit! Wrong button again. It says equip! It doesn't say... It doesn't even say... It's the first time I noticed that. Shouldn't it say... withdraw instead of equip? So I can equip this spigot. No, I cannot equip the spigot. Huh? Now I cannot equip a soul gem anymore, but I had just... when I pressed equip on the soul gem, it went into my inventory. What the hell is going on? Store, yeah. Anything else? Ingredients. Put that all away. Spam that X button. Blah. Spam that X button. We have enough food. We have enough potions. I believe we're all set. You goddamn right, we're all set. Let's get the hell out of here. Let's go to Bleak Files Barrows and get that gold claw and that other thing we were supposed to get there, which I forgot what exactly it was. Something, something. You guys make milk? No milk? Ooh. Hey! Ah, wrong button. Hey, don't you run. Wait for me, mate. Wait. I just want your meat. Not gonna hurt you. If you stand still. If you don't stand still, it's gonna hurt a lot. Let's not chase that deer too much. I wonder how that armor keeps increasing. We don't get hit. It's the second time the light armor increases without taking a hit. Alright, what do we have over there? Oh wait, that was the boss. There was a boss enemy over here, I believe. Yeah, we skipped him. Maybe he's still here. It was a giant wolf or a giant dog. Oh, that looks like a special one. What the hell? Who the hell is that? A hunter and a spriggan. Looks like a job for our flame Atronach. Please don't kill me. Well, the spriggan is probably... Oh, shit! I was gonna say the spriggan is gonna do all of the damage. Yep, it's gonna do all of the damage. I forgot to deposit the egg. God damn it. I said I was gonna deposit the egg. I opened the barrel to deposit the egg. And what do? I do not deposit the egg. What's wrong with me? Tell me, guys, what the fuck is wrong with me? This is not gonna kill us, right? Is it? Stop hitting me! Did the hunter die? Whoa! I suddenly see a whole lot of enemies on my screen. Hunter, you're dead? What? Are you, like, trying to attack me, Huntart? What? And a fox as well? Oh yeah, that's right, because the spriggan... The spriggan has a spell that makes the docile enemies, docile wild animals, animals around him attack me as well. Let's spam all this. Do we have... Yeah, let's just do that. Die! Come on, Huntart, are you gonna help or what? What? You're healing, but you just disappeared. You disappeared and you healed? How the hell could I hit you then? Oh man, we're so dead. We're so dead. Well, it's odd that I have no eating animation. You're not gonna heal again, are you? Whoa. The hell was that? What? Hunter? Oh, okay. I thought he was the red dot. I thought the hunter was the red dot, but it was this little wolf. Let's just get rid of him. Fox, whatever. It all comes down to the same thing. Where are you shooting at, mate?
You can't win this.
Where the hell are you shooting at? At a rabbit? There's probably some more rabbits down here then. Those red dots. Rabbits or more wolves or fish in the water. Or mud crabs. I want to go down and look, but... There's probably not going to be anything important down there. I can't really see it. Ah, yeah, that's a wolf. Probably three wolves then. Yep, another wolf there. Three wolves. Mr. Hunter, Mr. Hunter, Mr. Hunter. You're still in combat? God damn it, because those guys might be able to trade with us. Okay, well, I wanted to see if the big wolf was still here. Because last time we went over that bridge and we saw a big, gigantic-ass wolf. And we ran. Let's just do a quick save, because if he's behind the corner, there's a big chance he's gonna one-shot us. Not that I have any knowledge over it. Yep, Mr. Big Wolf is still there. Great Grey Wolf Synth. I thought it said Sith for a moment there. That would be a nice Dark Souls 3 reference. Are you gonna one-shot us? You probably are, right? Oh, no. His damage is the same as a regular wolf. Good to know. That means we will probably be able to kill him and get some nice experience. Well, the flames don't do much damage, so let's just bash his skull in. Are you gonna... No wait, I think... Who the hell are you? The Gravetender! Holy fuck! I think we will need to run. We will need to run. Ah! Leave me alone! How the hell are we gonna get to Bleakfell's barrows now? Whoa! Are you, Huntard's gonna help? Or is... Wait, I remember Bleakfell's barrows is on this road, yeah. Well, Mr. Gravetender, Mr. Big Ass Wolf, I'm not gonna kill you right now. Even though you do not do that much damage, I do even less damage on you. So we're gonna... Yeah, he just killed the hunter there. We might go back to see what the hunter had. How do they call those birds that prey on corpses? Vultures! Let's go and sneak in like a little vulture. Because I think that hunter will have some goodies. Come on. Just as I thought, some goodies! Water skin. A knapsack. Not gonna take that. You guys are not gonna attack Riverwood, are you? No, I think they're far enough from Riverwood. Is someone coming towards us? No, I think we're safe. Let's continue onwards. Bleakfell's barrows it is. Let's see if we can loot that little tower first. I think we can. Is this an iron rock? Iron ore vein. Are those still lighting up? Because I had a mod installed that made ores light up. But it seems like this one is not lighting up, or is it? I might be wrong. Looks like a regular vein. Oh no, from a distance it does look like a bit Huh, my cape just changed. What the hell? I look very dirty all of a sudden. The hell's up with that? Oh shit! Oh, bandits. Only bandits, no biggie, I hope. Right? You're not gonna kill me, are you guys? Oh, you're almost dead. Somebody already attacked you guys. Wow, that bandit has a lot of HP. Let's bash his skull in. Ho! That did a whole lot of damage. Whoa, holy shit, that guy has a lot of damage. Whoa, get away from me. You must level up. Restores 150 points of stamina. Yes, we are gonna do that. You're also going to eat a chicken breast. Where the hell is the food animation? The eating animation is gone. Ugh! Weird, the eating animation should prevent us from eating and attacking the whole time. Because this way we can just eat, attack, eat, attack, eat, attack, eat, attack. Which I wanted to prevent from happening. No goodies. Oh, garnets. Oh, that's better than nothing. What did you drop? Some gold. I think it's better if we wait until we can summon another Atronach. But let's see if we have a potion to restore some mana. And yes, we do. Whoa, what the hell? That's a deadly arrow. Good thing we have a lot of meat with us. Yeah, that's eating. Normally if we click an item to eat, except soup. But if we click an item to eat, like we do with drinking, our character should be immobilized for about 3 to 5 seconds during the eating animation. But it looks like it's not happening anymore, which is a shame. Because I did that so we cannot just spam healing items all the time. Because I hate that about Bethesda games, that you can just do that and not die. Oh yeah, you got great aim, man. Are you gonna miss? Are you gonna miss every shot? Or are those dudes hardcore? Oh, those dudes are hardcore, man. And who the hell killed you guys? Oh, Draugr. You guys got into a fight with a Draugr. I see. I'm just gonna ignore those fellas. And see if there's anything to loot here, because I don't think we'll be able to kill those markmans. They're a bit strong. If our Atronach does no damage, we will do even less damage. Yeah, let's just loot everything. I hope there's a chest here. Oh, we're not at the top floor yet. No chest. Oh. Called it too soon. Scroll of Mind Fog prevents the target from casting spells or regenerating magicka for 20 seconds. Bypasses spell absorption. There's some good stuff in this chest. Holy hell. Now let's see. Whoa. Okay. You guys do your thing and we'll jump down the mountain somewhere. I don't know. Can we do it like this? Yeah, we can, but it's gonna be hard, so I'm gonna skip it. That's our little house there. Those are lampposts that you see. Yeah, let's just head up to Bleak Files Barrows. But it's gonna be very hard. It's gonna be very hard inside. So I'm gonna save that level to level up, because that will restore our magicka to 100%. Is this actually the correct way? I think we're supposed to walk around the tower, right? But I don't want to do that right now. Let's see if we can get up by skill jumping. Yeah. And there's another enemy there. Let's do a quick save. Yeah, another archer. Iron arrows. Steel arrows, okay. That's an easy one compared to his brother. Whoa, that's a whole lot of enemies. How the hell are we gonna do that? That's a whole lot of enemies. And those from there are gonna, yeah, they're probably gonna flank us. I hope not. Is that normal, or these enemies? Ancient soldier Vark, what the hell? I installed too many hardcore enemy mods. We are gonna die. You're gonna get one shot, aren't we? Why don't you attack the bandits? They're like friends with the bandits. Uh-oh, shit, look at all these guys. Look at all these guys. Jezra's the explorer, where the hell are you going? How the hell am I surviving this long? I should have been killed like 50 times already. No, we will not be able to kill these dudes. Ah! I'm dodging bullets like I'm the fucking Neo, man. Like I'm fucking Neo from Matrix. Ah! This ain't gonna happen. I think we should be at least like level 20 or something. Or maybe we can just sneak in. Can we sneak in? And act like nothing happened? Yeah, let's just go inside. We have one teleportation in case we get stuck. Oh, and 45 minutes have already passed. Might as well end the episode here. Yeah, there's some dudes down there. I think everything inside the dungeons is like the vanilla. Whoa. Well, except the more hardcore enemies. But I don't think bosses and special enemies like those guys you saw outside and the big dog and stuff, I don't think those are located inside dungeons. So I think dungeons are still relatively safe, even though that's a poor choice of words, because there's still many hardcore enemies inside and no place to run other than the exit. But yeah, I'm gonna end the episode here. I thank you all for joining me. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like and maybe even consider subscribing. If you didn't like the video, please leave a dislike so I know what to work on. Thank you and see you all on the next episode. Bye bye.